Hi everyone, welcome back and great to see you. I'm Sharifah from the School of Fisheries and Aquaculture Sciences, UMT. Let me take you on a journey of broodstock management in seed production techniques. Broodstock management involves all the necessary measures done by the culturist to ensure captive broodstock undergo reproductive maturation, spawning, and produce fertilized eggs. Here, I will share with you the broodstock definition, where to collect the broodstock, how to control fish reproduction, how to improve broodstock quality, how to handle broodstock properly, how to transport broodstock, how to manage feeding, how to manage broodstock health, and how to biosecure your broodstock facility. At the end of the topic, you will be equipped with the knowledge on proper broodstock management techniques for sustainable seed production. What is broodstock, or sometimes called broodfish? They are mature individuals used in aquaculture for breeding purposes to produce or increase the number of seeds. Broodstock can originate from the wild or domesticated. For wild broodstock, they are collected from the wild, require careful handling and transportation to your hatchery, needs to be disinfected, quarantined, and conditioned to captivity. On the other hand, domesticated broodstock are selected by breeders based on their best criteria and are already accustomed to rearing condition, hence less stress. Planning of breeding strategy in the future are easily anticipated. Why are broodstock important in seed production? They are important because culturists depend on this broodstock to produce continuous, sustainable and good quality seed supply to support the increasing aquaculture demand. And the success of seed production depends largely on proper broodstock management. Broodstock management is also expensive because it requires more space, manpower and nutritious feed as well as careful handling. In order to achieve that, a hatchery manager or an operator has a lot to think about, such as how is the performance of last season, how to make improvement, how is the broodstock performance now, what is the number of broodstock, what is the number of spawn, what is the weight of broodstock, how many eggs can be produced per kilogram of female broodstock? How is the larval and fingerling performances? At certain stocking density of fry, how fast can they grow? Are the fingerlings smaller or larger than the last spawn? How many females actually spawn? What is the age of the broodstock? Wow, that is a lot to think about. Before you even start to select good quality broodstock, it is important that you first know the reproductive capacity of that species. That includes the size at maturity, method of reproduction, habitat and feeding behavior, and whether they are tolerant towards adverse environmental condition. For the success of seed production, you need to have full control of the sexual maturation and spawning in order to produce and supply sustainable all-year-round seeds. Without control, farmers need to rely on collection of wild broodstock, larvae or fry, and more often, the availability and quality of wild broodstock are inconsistent. Reproductive control can be achieved by induced spawning, either through hormone injection, environmental manipulation, or both. There are various types of hormone that can induce the maturation, such as human chorionic gonadotropin, pituitary glands, ovaprim, ovaplant, and suprefect, among others. Reproductive control can also be achieved through cryopreservation for short-term preservation or storage of gametes at low temperature. Cryopreservation overcomes problems like temporary shortage of gamete, asynchrony in natural and artificial spawning, transportation of gametes, disease control, selective breeding and hybridization. Hence, fertilization and seed production can still be performed. Hatchery farmers should be able to improve production and profits by using these technologies. 1. Inbreeding. 2. Selective breeding. 3. Hybridization. And 4. Crossbreeding. Inbreeding is the mating of relative or close related species. Often, it resulted in poor quality seeds, but with proper techniques, it can be effective and produce outstanding breeds. Selective breeding involves choosing parents with beneficial characteristics, producing offspring with those traits. It may take a few generations of selective breeding to achieve the desirable traits. Hybridization is the breeding of two species or genera that do not normally interbred in order to produce hybrid vigor that possibly combines the positive traits of both parents. Crossbreeding involves breeding of unrelated strains of the same species, similarly aimed at producing better quality seeds. Broodstock can be reared in different culture systems such as cage, pond, and tanks depending on species, size, behavior, and preference of the fish. Optimum stocking density, water quality, feeding and well-being of broodstock is the number one priority to ensure gonad maturation in captivity. At times, handling of broodstock is necessary for broodstock selection, weighing, hormone injection, tagging, transportation, and etc. It should be noted that broodstock should be handled after a 24-hour fasting period and handled with care. Fish should be anesthetized prior to handling. Place broodstock carefully in an anesthetic bath for a few minutes to calm fish down to reduce stress or injuries. Do not leave fish too long in the anesthetic bath as fish may die. Make sure fish have regained consciousness before returning into the rearing tank, as fish might stay at the bottom and suffocate to death due to mud, accumulated feces and debris. Examples of commonly used anesthesia are MS-222, 2-phenoxyethanol, clove oil mixture and transmol. The dose depends on the species and size, and the fish should be observed constantly to avoid overdose. To hold the broodstock, place the fish slowly in a moist towel, cover the eyes and carry just like a baby. You can also use a fish stretcher or fish bag to transfer fish. Do not hold the caudal peduncle as it will cause stress, injuries and unsafe. Fish may struggle and fall onto the floor. Transportation of broodstock should be carefully done to avoid injuries, stress, or eventually death of the fish. For big broodstock, transport in dark-colored and covered tanks containing aerated or oxygenated water to reduce stress. Mild sedation is recommended to reduce stress, easier and safer handling. Fish should not be fed at least 24 hours prior to prevent defecation of feces and regurgitation of feed, causing fouling of transport water. Transportation tanks should be filled with clean water. Tanks should be round in shape or square with rounded corners to avoid skin abrasions and mechanical shocks. Tanks should be large enough to allow the fish a fair degree of movement. Proper management of broodstock requires individual identification of brooders to monitor the livestock, to record individual events, to plan future induced breeding, to avoid multiple injections of the same species, to identify and record the best brooders. There are two types of tags, the internal tags and the external tags. Internal tags will be inserted into the fish muscle or body cavity, while external tags will be attached outside the fish body. One of the commonly used internal tags is the pit tags. It is easy to implement, do not have tag rejection, has unique individual code, easy to detect and read, not perishable, but it is expensive. Now, how do you implant the pit tags in fish? First, disinfect the pit tags with alcohol, then insert the pit tag into an adaptable needle. Implant pit tag in the muscle close to the dorsal fin. The pit tag is automatically detected and its number can be read using a pit tag reader. External tags are easily detectable, do not require device for detection, carry individual code visible for reporting, cheap, simple to produce, easy and fast to implement and suitable for various fish size and species. External tags are available in different colors, shapes, sizes and types known as dart and anchor tags, spaghetti tags and streamer tags. The disadvantages of external tags are they may affect growth, behavior, health and survival. This may be due to injury and muscle tearing at the place of attachment, leading to infections, continuous drag on the protruding tags and fouling of the tags. The overgrowth of algae or mussels may increase the drag on the tag and also make detection difficult. The tag may become entangled in aquatic vegetation or netting, and the chance of tag loss is high. External tags may also be difficult to apply to small fish. Proper broodstock nutrition and feeding management improve reproductive performance and quality of seeds. Trash fish is commonly fed to broodstock because it is cheap, highly palatable, and resembles natural food, especially for carnivorous species. Trash fish should be purchased fresh, cleaned, minced and deep frozen. The disadvantages of trash fish is that they are inconsistent in supply, require intense work for preparation, unstable in quality and easily deteriorates, have storage difficulty, high risk of pathogen infection, affects water quality and usually the nutrient requirements are not met. In order to overcome the problems of trash fish, artificial feed can be used. They are available as pellets or moist feed, made into different sizes and can be in the floating, slow sinking or sinking form depending on fish requirements. The advantages of artificial pellets are they are formulated to fish requirement, readily available, easily stored, having longer shelf life, less affecting water quality and are able to be used on auto feeder. The disadvantages of artificial feeds are they are expensive and the structure is not similar to the natural food. To ensure proper nutrition and feeding management, use feeds that are specifically formulated for the species and age of the fish. Besides that, purchase quality feeds from recognized suppliers and use appropriate feeding rates for the age and condition under which they are being reared. Ensure the texture and size of feeds, palatability and frequency or timing of feeding are optimized. Feeds should be stored according to the manufacturer's instructions to avoid damage. Health management is an important aspect in broodstock management. Although prevention is better than cure, the broodstock is susceptible to disease infections from bacteria, fungus, parasites and virus. To control or prevent disease infections, it is crucial to conduct screening on broodstock before stocking and reproduction as well as the live feed before feeding. This is especially critical for broodstock or live feed obtained from the wild or other farms. Biosecurity of facility is as important in order to minimize disease transfer. Restrict visitors and vehicular traffic. Prepare vehicle tire bath, foot bath, and hand washing station at entry into each separate culture area. Encircle entire facility with chain link fence and crab barriers. Disinfect all water entering the facility with ozone or UV. Adopt recirculation systems in maturation and broodstock raceways to reduce water usage and effluence. Treat all water effluence before releasing into the environment. Perform one-way movement of personnel, materials and fish. Do not introduce other live animals. Separate various functional areas. Disinfect and clean all equipment thoroughly. Monitor pathogens and disease routinely. Optimize water quality and nutrition to improve overall health and resistance of fish. Well, now you know the basic husbandry and management practices of broodstock. Remember that the way we manage the broodstock is the key to the well-being of broodstock, its gamete and seeds quality. Till next time, thank you.